comes to mind, the coach made 12 trips to the Final Four in 27 years at UCLA, winning a record, think about it, 10 national championships. And 22 years ago today, he coached his final game, defeating Kentucky for the national championship. And I'm pleased to welcome the legend from Martinsville, Indiana, John Wooden, to our show. Coach, nice to see you. Does it seem like 22 years?
No, time slips by, and particularly as you get older, it goes faster and faster. But it is nice to be back in Indiana, my home state.
You know, a lot of friends there, they've all been waving at. How much has the game, of course, has changed a lot. What are the changes in your mind to the game of basketball in those years?
Since the time I retired, well, gracious sakes, two rule changes have made quite a difference. The three-point goal, also the clock that you didn't have. I think that's made a big difference. And then the players are so much more athletic. I think the athleticism of the players today is just remarkable. But I think as the players have become better, we've lost a little team play. I think the tendency is that because they are so good individually, don't let them go on their own a little too much. And that's hurt team play a little. But gee, I marvel at the athleticism of them.
Coach, if you could comment on what you valued most in a player that played under you, what kind of skills were you looking for in a player that you'd like to see most?
Well, the first thing I always looked for, I wanted a player quicker than the opposition in the particular position. I hope my guards will be quicker than opposing guards, forwards, and postmen. And after that, I wanted them players that would look for the pass first. I wanted the vast majority of my baskets to come at the end of a pass, not the end of a dribble.
Coach, today, a lot of coaches are just happy to get to the Final Four. You almost always won when you went to the Final Four. What kind of mindset did you try to create in your players?
Obviously, anyone that gets to the Final Four, you have to feel pretty good about it, but you would like to go all the way. And if you can just concentrate on the things that got you there. I think in my early years, I didn't do well in tournament when I started out, and I think I wanted it so much that I overworked them, both physically and mentally. And finally, when I got over that, I said it took me a long time to learn, but once I got it, I had it down pretty good.
Coach, I think it's...
Yeah, I would say you had it pretty good.
I think his real question was, how can he win 10 championships? But do you think you could dominate today, Coach?
I didn't understand.
Do you think you could dominate the game today like you did?
No. I was at the right time at the right place. I've been blessed. The Lord's blessed me very much.
What about tonight's game? What do you see in tonight's game?
Oh, it's a great game. I enjoyed it. It's what a championship game should be. A real tight, and it's real good. I've been impressed with the way that Arizona has been able to counter the pressure from Kentucky very well. And they have done an excellent job on Mercer. There's no question about it. And that's hurt Kentucky to some extent. But it's anybody's game, and that's just the way it should be.
You know, everybody knows the coach as the Wizard of Westwood, but I bet you guys didn't know that he was once known as the Indiana Rubber Man. Did you know that? Why was that?
Well, there were those who said I bounced up a lot when I got out of the floor.
Still got a bounce in your step, too, Coach. Nice to see you. Always a pleasure to have you here. Thank you.
Thank you, Pat. Thank you, Clark.